So, hello and welcome to the Sports Babble. We have just after watching Spain on the 21s, play Northern Ireland on the 21s and UEFA on the 21s qualifying in a very cold Port of Ireland Shamrock Park. Finished by 3, it was a good game.
Very entertaining game.
Did you enjoy it, Jake?
Certainly. That'll be one word to describe it.
What did you think of Mikel Moreno? Because I know you're a fan of his.
Very impressed, you know, I think he controlled him and Danny Ceballos there, you know, they were definitely commanding in the midfield, and I suppose that's what guaranteed Spain the victory in the end. Some incisive passes as well, as it's all about maintaining possession, you know, in easy areas, but they played incisive passes at decisive times, and that's what made the difference in this game, and so we separated them from Northern Ireland.
Ceballos sort of, he didn't play what he thought he'd play as a striker up front, he dropped really, really deep.
Yeah, we noticed that from early on. Actually, it took Spain maybe 10, 15 minutes to get used to the surface, shall we say.
Yeah.
But once it did, Ceballos dropped in and started to control the game from there. I think, you know, from the team sheet, he's starting as part of the front three.
Yeah.
He really dropped in deep, and at times he was the deepest player. Force being on the pitch.
Yeah, he was centre half.
But when he did come in there, that's when they controlled the game, and that's when they had a lot of the ball, and that's when they did all their good work.
It wasn't all about Spain though. Northern Ireland, I thought, played very, very well.
Yeah.
At one point, it made it 3-0 and kept dragging themselves back into it. Mark Sykes from Glenavon.
Yes.
Was hooped a double nutmeg to set up Shane Lowry for the equaliser.
Super.
But the Northern Ireland boys were pretty happy with their performance in the end.
I think, you know, they're reassuring there, you know, they're sitting in second place in the group. It's, I suppose, a night which could have been better, but also could have been worse. You know, they've managed to stay with players, you know, a team made up of players from very top level clubs, like, you know, and trained with top level coaches. I suppose, you know, there was a key decision there after the 3-0 draw. Northern Ireland had a corner kick. Ball was played in, and just after it was played in, at number 7, Paul Smith from QPR was hauled to the ground. Should have been a penalty, you know, and then Spain go up and make it 4-3. On nights like this, those are the things need to go for Northern Ireland, and they just didn't.
Very
quickly
after that, as well, Spain scored, and then you felt the atmosphere just drop down after that.
In the first half, Boya Mujeral from Real Madrid, he had two glorious chances to score, and he didn't take them, and then in the second half, he woke up and got himself a hat-trick.
Yeah, and I'm saying, you know, wasn't in the game a lot, Mayoral, but he was there at the decisive moments, and that's where the quality comes through. And
his first
you want
goal,
him just to be there when you need to score the goals, and you know, came out with a second half hat trick.
And his first goal was a little flick, driven across the box from Carlos Soler. Soler was interesting as well because they dropped him in the midfield then in the centre half, or in the second half in the centre midfield. But overall, what did you think then of the game of the Spanish team or the Northern Ireland team? If anyone stood out for you apart from Ceballos?
Sex stood out, exactly.
Sex,
I know we were saying that probably random, maybe, I'm sure there were scouts here tonight, you know, from Premier League Championship clubs even. You know, I'm sure he'd be in some of their minds after tonight.
I suppose he's the sort of player, you know, a lot of, you know, I don't mean to be bad, a lot of other players prefer to pass sideways and backwards, but he's a player that can really drive through the lines. He's a player they need to harness and to make the most of, you know. In terms of the Premier League, maybe, you know, we'll see some of these players. Of course, Adama Traoré played there last year. Mikel Merino is there this year. Any other Spanish players you think might make it?
Well, there's ones that are in La Liga. I think Fabian, he was number 5 tonight for Spain. I think he was class. Mm. I was really impressed with him. Obviously, we said Mikel Merino, who's at Newcastle. Those two in midfield, as long as Ceballos just really controlled the tempo of the game at times. But, the pitch sort of evened it out a bit because it wasn't the best pitch they'll ever play on.
It was low at times,
it was rainy and it was sticky and cold, but overall, a really good match. It was free in, there was nearly 3,000 people here as well watching.
What comes to mind is, you know, before Guardiola came to be manager of Manchester City, they all said, I wonder how he would set up a team on a real cold night in Stoke City. You know, top managers, top players can adapt to these situations. It might take them a little bit of time, but they did.
Yeah, after 10 minutes, the Spain boys really got to grips of the game, didn't they?
Yeah.
So, but yeah, I was happy enough for that. Thursday night's entertainment.
Certainly.
Yeah, excellent, for free.
Yeah, for free. So we'll see you again next week. Make sure you check us out on our social media pages at the Sports Babble. There's something you're going to say there, Jake?
No,
jump
good, night.
In. Good night. Good night. Keep going on our competition. We're almost at 500 likes, and then you can win yourself a Premier League top of your choice. See you later. Good luck.